Dear students, now we are going to revise chapter question tags. A question tag is a short question added onto a statement in speech. In speech, we add question tag, and afterward, after statement, we add question tag for getting that the statement is true or not. In positive sentence, if the sentence is positive, we will include negative question tag, and if the sentence will be negative, we will use positive question tag. Look at the word structure. First, we will use auxiliary plus not. We are getting that in this sentence it is Friday today. The sentence is positive, so we are including negative question tag. First, we are adding is auxiliary, afterward not. Understand? Is not it? We are including in this way. So we will use what? Auxiliary plus not plus pronoun. Understand? So you are getting is not it. If the sentence is negative, you don't know him. So we are including what? Positive question tag. Do you? Here you are getting what is structure? Auxiliary plus pronoun. Our auxiliary is what here? Do. And afterward we will use pronoun you. Understand? Student, you have to note that with I am, the tag is or not I. If I am in a sentence, in a statement, we will use question tag or not I. Look at the example, I am taller than you. The question tag will be or not I. Understand? Positive sentence, so negative question tag. If you are getting suggestion in a sentence and the sentence starts with let us. So let's take a taxi. If the sentence is included with let us, so on that time we will use shall we question tag. Question tag will be shall we. In a sentence where it will be started with the sentence which will started with let us. Understand? Especially in suggestion. Order or request. If the sentence is in order or in request, on that time we will use question tag. Can you or could you? Keep in your mind. Wait a minute. Can you close the window? Could you? Understand? Don't. If you are getting don't in a statement starting, especially it will be in order. The word don't talk here. Especially it is order. So if don't is used on that time, we will only use will. You don't you means we are going to use will you. Understand? Especially in imperative sentence in order. There is, am, are, was, were. If in sentence we are getting is, am, are with there, was, were, then we will use question tag. Is not there, are not there, was not there. According to, if the sentence will be positive, negative question tag, and if the statement is negative, positive question tag. Dear students, the next chapter is, so do I, neither do I. We use the pattern so plus auxiliary plus subject to say that a statement about one thing or person is also true about another thing or person. In the simple present, do does, and in simple past we use did. Understand? So look at the example. So do I, neither do I. We are using here so plus auxiliary plus subject to say that something about one thing or another person is true. Understand? Is also true to another thing or person. Suppose that, look at the example. If the statement is positive, I can swim, so we will use so plus auxiliary can, then subject here, I. Understand? In negative statement, we will use neither plus auxiliary plus subject. He does not like bread. Neither do I. We can use neither do I or nor do I. Neither do I is more significant, is formal. Understand? In comparison of nor do I. Understand? Dear students, now we will revise next chapter. The chapter name is Uses of Modal Verbs, Can, Could, May, Might, Will, etc. Understand? In this chapter, we will know about the uses of all these. Can, could, may, might. We often use can to talk about ability in present. Understand? Or we can say that know how to. She can operate the computer. Means that she knows how to operate the computer, or she is able to operate the computer. Understand? Could is also used for the ability in the past. I could swim when I was 7. Could is used for showing ability in the past. Can and may are used for permission. May is rather formal. Can and may are used for taking permission and for giving permission. May is formal and can is informal. Understand? So you can say that you can park your car there for giving permission. And for taking permission, we also can use. Visitors may use the swimming pool between 7 a.m. and 7 p.m. It is formal. Understand? Can I use your umbrella? It is informal. May I go home early today? For taking permission, we can use can or may. May is formal, can is informal. But if we are going to give permission on that time, we can also use could. Could I read your newspaper? Could is more polite than may or can. Understand? But if we are asking question, could I read your newspaper? The answer will be, of course you can. Your answer will not be, of course you could. Could, of course you could not be used. Understand? We also use may, might and could to say something is possible. We can use them for the present or future. In the present and for in the future, we will use may, might and could to say something is possible. Understand? Might is little less than may and could is less than may and might. Understand? Students, we use can and could for asking something. Suppose that we ask someone to do something, then we can use can and could. So, can you help me? Could you help me? Could is more polite than can. Understand? Afterward, could and might refer to past time in the fall. Suppose that could and might also are used for indicating about past. She said that I could might sit down. Understand? Students, afterward we are going to know about the use of will, would, shall, should. Will is used to tell about the future. We can also use shall with I and we only. But the word will be used with all the pronouns, with all the subject. Understand? With everything. Dear students, we use shall I in question, especially interrogative sentence. Shall I if we want to do something, to offer something to someone, shall I close the window? On that time we can use shall I get a ticket for you. Afterward we can also use shall I when we want to know someone's opinion, or when we want advice. When we want advice someone's opinion, on that time we will use shall I. Which bag shall I buy? Shall I buy this book? We use shall we to ask or make suggestion. To ask or for make suggestion, to give suggestion or to take suggestion, we use shall we. What shall we do now? We are taking suggestion. Understand? Shall we take a taxi? We are making suggestion, make suggestion or ask suggestion. Understand? Afterward we will use will, would you, to make request. Would you is more polite than will you. Will you pass the sugar? Would you pass the sugar? Would you is more polite than will you. Understand? Dear students, afterward we will use would you like. Would you like when we offer food or drink. When we offer food or drink, on that time we will use what? Would you like? Would you like a tea? Especially when we are going to offer food or drink. Would you like some more rice? Understand? We use should. What is the correct or good thing to do? We use should to tell about what is the correct thing to do. You should respect your elders. You should complete the work. Now, dear students, we are going to know about the use of must, ought to, and need not. We use must when something is necessary or very important. Understand? I must get up at 5 tomorrow. It is more important. We can use must. We must see the doctor as early as possible. Means that this condition is critical. On that time, we will use must. Understand? When situation is serious, it is very important. We also use have to talk about necessary or obligation. To talk about necessity or obligation, we have to complete the work. He has to complete the work. Necessity or obligation. But the difference between must and has to, have to, are that has to and have to are used when there is an external pressure. The pressure is that I have to be home by 10 o'clock. It means that there is an external pressure of the parents or anybody. So we have to reach, I have to reach the home by 10 o'clock. To talk about the past, we use had to. Must has no past tense. We don't use must in past tense. We use had to. To talk about necessity or obligation in the past. Understand? We also use must when we suppose that something is certain. Suppose that when something is certain, we use must. He must be over 70. Means that it is certain that he is over 70. Afterward, in the opposite of must is can't, not must not. Opposite of must is what? Must. Opposite of must is can't, not must not. He can't be over 70. I am certain that he is not over 70. We use ought to, should, just like should, to say what is good thing or right thing to do. You are to respect your elders. You are to respect your teachers. You are to respect your parents. Especially moral obligation. For moral obligation, we use ought to, just like a should. Understand? Dear students, we use need not or don't have to when we are going to say that something is unnecessary. Suppose that we need not, don't have to wash the car. It is clean. It means that the car is clean. So, it need not, we need not to wash the car. We don't have to wash the car. Afterward, you must not wash the car. The difference, you have to know about the difference. You must not wash the car. The paint is still wet. The reason is that the paint is still wet. Understand? So you must not wash. It's very important not to wash the car because car is clean. Compare also. You need not, don't have to come. You must come. You must not come. Means that if we are telling, you need not, don't have to come. Suppose that your work has been completed. So you are going, your exam is approaching, half yearly exam is approaching, and you are going to tuition. So the tuition teacher will say that you need not, don't have to come. It means that it is not necessary for you to come because your syllabus has been completed. You have to revise the syllabus at your home. You must not come. Don't come. You must not come means, you must not come means it is an order. It indicates about order, this statement. We can use don't, need to instead of don't have to. Suppose that we are using we don't need to wash the car. We can also use we don't need to come. We don't need to wash the car. We don't need to come in place of need not, don't have to. In place of need not and don't have to, we will use what? Don't need. Understand? Dear students, the next chapter is comprehension, afterward paragraph writing. Comprehension means understanding. In comprehension passage, you will get passage. And from the passage, you will read the passage. After reading the passage, you will get some questions. And from the passage, you will get the answer of the question that are given at last of the paragraph, unseen paragraph. Understand? Unseen passage. So, comprehension means understanding. You have to understand the passage and try to find out the answer of the questions that are given in paragraph by your understanding skill. Comprehension, comprehend, the another word, comprehend means understand. Understand? Afterward, we are coming paragraph writing. Students, you know that paragraph means a paragraph is made up of a group of sentences which are related to one idea or topic. In paragraph writing, it will be related to one idea or topic. Topic will be one, idea will be related on one idea or topic. Understand? So you get paragraphs in a story, in essays, in letter. Understand? So you know that paragraphs deals with one topic or idea, and this idea is usually summed up in one sentence. Especially in one sentence, you get the idea of paragraph, and this sentence is called the topic sentence. Understand? So in paragraph, you know that first, there will be in starting, in the middle of starting, you will write the heading, title. Afterward, you will start the paragraph. Understand? So first we will write the topic sentence, and afterward we will write the sentences in support of the topic. Understand? The topic sentence comes at the beginning of the paragraph. Understand? Sometimes it will be come at the end of paragraph. And one thing you must keep in the mind, you must only write the factual thing, facts and important things about paragraph writing. You have not to write a story just like you are writing in essays or in a story. You have not to give your own opinion or idea. You have to write only the things, the facts, understand? The important things. Dear students, this is your last topic, writing notices. We have also discussed earlier. A notice is a short composition meant to convey a piece of information to some people who could be interested in it. The information could be about an event that has already taken place or is about to take place in the near future. Notices, you are getting notices in your school notice board. It will display for what purpose? It is a piece of information to convey to some people who could be interested in it. The information could be an event that has already taken place. The event which has already taken place or is going to take place in the future. Suppose that, what will be the event? A cultural event may be a play, dance, performance, etc. A sports event, a meeting or a birth, marriage, death, etc. For that purposes, notices are put on the notice board. Understand? And you have to participate in different programs in schools with the help of notice. Understand? Whatever notices are published, notices are pasted on the, notices are pasted on the notice board. Students, how to write a notice, you have to keep in your mind. Notice must be written you have to line, make a rectangular, we can say that, in rectangular portion you can write the notice. Remember that in notice what must be included? A heading. First of all, you will write the heading. The heading must be of your organization, about your school name. Afterward, the date. Under the heading, it will be date. In left side, date of writing the notice. Clear, complete information. Afterward, you will write the content. Whatever the topic is about which you are going to write the notice. Understand? The content will be clear and complete with full information. Afterward, at last, in left side, you will write your name and designation of the writer. There will be designation and name of the writer. Understand? So this must be included in notice. So I hope that you have understood all this clearly. Thanks for watching the video. Best of luck for your half-yearly examination. Thank you.